want to get back to my NBA path to chasing that. So that's where I was at, bro, with my JUCO thing.
So when you went to USC and you played, JT, what was like some of your highlights at USC, some of your favorite moments at Southern Cal?
Beating UCLA.
Okay.
That night was crazy.
I remember seeing you hit a game winner, too.
That was at Wake.
At Wake, yep.
Against Iowa.
Against Iowa. I remember. Weren't they at Iowa, Cody?
No, we was at Wake.
No, it was at Wake. Yeah.
That was that Big Ten challenge that they always do, Big Ten ACC thing.
Yeah.
That was freshman year, too. Young JT.
That game right there put me on the map, bro.
Mm-hmm. For real. Because you had, what, 30?
32.
Oh.
That moment was surreal, bro.
Who, JT, we got to ask you this. Me and Will were talking. Who was the – you know, we know you like to embarrass people. Who was the first person that, like, gave you a bucket?
The first person that, like, gave me a bucket?
College, high school, like, who were some people that, like – maybe people don't know or big names, whatever.
All right,
like,
so I'm gonna tell y'all this right here, straight up. This how I first met John Wall.
Oh Lord.
Uh
oh.
I'm tell you, it's how I first met John Wall. I think I was like 10 or 11, and Johnny a year older than me. But he came to Fairchild with Garden Road Bulldogs. I was playing with the Burlington Stars at the time. We played against John in there. I had a 30 ball, but John had fucking 55 points, bro. And we was that young.
Oh, my God.
That's the first time where I said, shit, I got to step it the fuck up.
Hey, look, you only play like 21 minutes in the game when you're that young, too. Look, what was
he? Bro, he had 55. Fast as fuck, all layups to the rack.
Fast break. He had 25 transition buckets.
Good God.
That joint was crazy. But other than that, in high school, I think the best matchup that I had was me and John went head-to-head with Kenny Boynton and Brandon Knight.
Kenny Boynton that played at Florida, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm a Gator fan. So
that right there was probably the best matchup that was, you know what I mean? Anybody else that they was trying to put in front of me. And when it was time to eat, I ate. But Brandon Knight, I think that game right there, bro, was a hell of a match. I did my thing and he did his thing, as well as John and Kenny. That right there was that's on film too. We was in Vegas playing against each other.
Okay. What about in college?
In college. You know what, bro? I might say in college. Who gave me a bucket in college? KCP.
Okay, from Georgia?
Yeah.
That played Kentavious Caldwell Pope.
Oh. Yeah, he gave us like 30-something, and it was easy. And it was real easy for him, too.
he mad long, yo.
It's crazy. But, yeah, man, that's dope, JT. Like, we're getting some real live info, man, that a lot of people don't know about you.
Yeah, my brother, your family, I let you in.
Yes, sir. Always.
You know what?
And once again, everybody, yo, this is JT Terrell we got on here, man. Long time freaking North Carolina basketball phenom. Now playing overseas in Australia, as you heard. Just overall great dude, bro. Straight baller, though. Y'all just check him out on everything, bro. Like, he's definitely made a name for himself with Brock in his hand, for sure.
So, JT, it's crazy. So, like, you know, with the quarantine and stuff, a lot of people are on IG Live and stuff. I was actually listening. I think it was PJ Tucker, and, like, he had might have been Des Wells on there with him. And, you know, they were kind of talking about, like, some of the coldest hoopers to come out of North Carolina. And they were, you know, they talk about John, CP. But then they mentioned, like, your name and Ian Miller. And it's crazy because people who are from North Carolina realize, like, how good you are. Like, you might be underrated to a lot of people, but people from here, they know.
Yeah, back home, I get a lot of respect, man. You know, that's why I said, you know, especially like growing up in Burlington, but even, you know, North Carolina, especially on the hoop scene, it's a lot of love and respect between the ones that really do it. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. So listen, I want to ask you some questions like not basketball related.
Okay.
So what's JT bumping right now? If I pull up and see you at the light, like what are you bumping in the car?
What I'm bumping in the whip, I'm going to say either some Young Boy or some Lil Baby.
Hey, that's what I'm screaming, bro. I'm probably just saying that. Look, yeah. I'm that humble. At all in.
Yeah. All in, go crazy.
Crazy, bro.
At all in, go crazy. But yeah, if I got to damn pick a song that, all right, this right here, what I'm about to turn up to, probably pick some Young Boy, yo.
Yeah, what about that, that We Paid, too, with 42 Doug? That y'all right.
They go crazy.
That y'all.
That's Keese and Day Day's song right there.
Yeah. Hey, Lil Baby can't miss, though. He can't miss, bro.
Hey, bro. He snapped, dog. He definitely snapped.
Oh, yeah, Will. You want to ask your questions, bro?
We usually do, like, a final five questions and everything.
Okay.
These five questions and everything, JT. And but first, I'm going to introduce it. Today's final five is brought to you by Manscaped, who is the best in men's below-the-belt grooming. Manscaped is the top of the line when it comes to grooming essentials. Men, you must take pride in grooming and taking care of your body. Manscaped offers precision engineered tools for your family jewels. Perfect package, which includes the Lawnmower 3.0, is a stellar option for your trimming needs. It's waterproof and has skin-safe technology to ensure no nicks and cuts. Go to manscaped.com and use STORY20, all caps, at checkout for 20% off and free shipping. Again, that is coupon code STORY20, all caps, at checkout for 20% off and free shipping. So, yeah, you good for that too, Cody, for doing that.
Shout out Manscaped.
Manscaped for sure. But, all right, JT, bro, your first question from me today of the final five is, who is your favorite basketball team and all-time favorite basketball player?
Favorite basketball team? I would say probably Miami Heat, the way LeBron.
Okay. Just like LeBron. Heat, you always love the Heat just because of that.
Yeah, but then again, at the same time, it's like I'm a LeBron fan, so I really
rock with LeBron. Where's LeBron at? Like,
yeah, it's for real.
Cool, you know? Can say that too, bro. It's cool. Nowadays, bro, that's cool. Like, you know how it
is. Yeah, that's what I'm on. Favorite player of all time, though? Got to go with Mike. The greatest player of all time.
Sure.
He did it all.
Respectful. Respectful. So question two of the final five is, who's your favorite superhero?
My favorite superhero.
It can be an actual superhero. It can be like your favorite superhero from a movie. Like you know what I'm saying? I always tell people my favorite superhero is like Hancock from the Will Smith joint. Like
word.
Anything like that, bro.
I'm gonna say maybe Superman or Batman for real.
Man or Batman, okay. Okay.
And then again, I'm an Aladdin fan too, bro.
What?
Aladdin?
Yeah. Never heard that one before.
That's my guy
right there. I wasn't expecting that, bro. Okay.
That's my guy right there.
You seen the new one with Will Smith?
Yeah, I seen that joint. Had to.
But yeah, all right. So question three of the final five is, if you had to have a superpower, which one would you choose? It could be any one.
I think I would probably damn want to read people's thoughts, bro. I want to know what, you know, what people really think about me or what you're saying in your head when you're around me.
For real, though. All right, that's a good one. That's actually a new one. We ain't got that one before on the story. Yeah, all right. But question four, what's your favorite childhood cartoon?
Aladdin. Rugrats. Ren and Stimpy.
Used to, bro, you ever seen, you remember this show? You might not. It was called Codename Kids Next Door.
Kids Next Door. That was my
favorite. Bro, they used to be that joint, bro.
Yeah, they all had the numbers, number 1, 2, 3. Yeah, yeah.
That, bro, and Rocket Power, bro. You remember
Rocket
that?
Rocket Power was lit, too.
Oh.
Yeah, cool. Rocket Power was my favorite.
Last question of the final five tonight, brought to you by Manscaped, is, what's your favorite food or food genre? So if you do you like Italian, you know, American?
I'm a seafood man.
Seafood, okay. What type?
Snow crab legs. That's my favorite.
Okay.
And shrimp, man. Crab legs and shrimp.
Can't go wrong. So if you got shrimp, how you rather have it? Fried, grilled?
I want it either boiled or grilled.
Grilled? Okay, for sure, for sure. For sure, for sure. But yeah, that's the final five for today, bro. We appreciate you coming on and everything, JT, bro. It was great talking to you, bro. Finally to meet you and everything, bro. Yeah,
for real, man. You know, hey, we had to meet like this, but we'll meet in person one day, bro.
Oh yeah, for sure. I've heard so many things about you, bro. Watched so many videos. You know, it's just amazing to finally just get to meet you, bro. And you know, and just get to talk to you and pick your brain for a little bit.
Appreciate you, my brother. Thank y'all for having me.
So, JT, the last question we ask everybody, who's a guest that we should get on the Sideline Story podcast?
Ooh.
And you gotta
plug us in.
Okay.
You put us
okay.
on.
Okay. Let me see what I can do. I can get y'all Ian Miller for sure.
All right.
Okay.
I can do that.
I'm with
keep
it.
Keep it basketball. We can tap in like that. I hit some of my basketball brothers.
For okay, sure. Awesome.
Appreciate it, bro. And I'm sure our fans will absolutely love it, bro. You know what I'm saying?
For sure.
And thank you for joining us again, man. Always, you know, it's always a pleasure talking to you.
Yes, sir. It's always love, my brother. Appreciate y'all, man.
Yes, sir, JT.
All right, fellas. Appreciate it, man. Y'all be safe.
Same to you.
Yes, sir.
That was a great conversation. And also our first basketball guest on the Sideline Story podcast, another Burlington legend and a guy who's one of the best scorers, high school scorers that I've ever seen.
Hands down, just one of the most phenomenal scorers in North Carolina history, if you would ask me. You come to the state of North Carolina, you go anywhere, and you ask about the name JT Terrell, you get one word, and that's bucket. And still to this day, I mean, the guy's playing overseas. He's still trying to further his career in basketball. And it just shows you just how far basketball can take you. No, he isn't in the NBA yet, but he's has his family all out in Australia, and he's out there still on his grind, you know. And JT, from what I've heard and what I know about JT, I know he's always been a person who will never give up on his dreams and will always be a remembered hooper in the area that we're from, for sure.
No doubt. And once again, thank you to everybody tuning in and all our listeners and all the support that you've given the Sideline Story podcast. Once again, subscribe and rate. We're available on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, iHeartRadio, all streaming platforms. Feel free to hit us up with suggestions, guests you'd like to see, topics you'd like to hear discussed. And we just love your input. And thank you for your support.
And we out.
Nobody tell me what I ain't gonna be no more. You're thinking I'm a fall, don't be so sure. I wish somebody made guidelines on how to get up off the sidelines.